Greetings, Mitch Mitchay, the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. Well, I got an email asking me about, I've mentioned in several of my videos, about restoring the wood grain on the front grill for the Ambarola. This actually works for any kind of wood grain. On the horn of the Edison Ambarola X. Lots of ways to utilize this restoration for this wood grain that's basically painted on metal surfaces. It's really simple, it's really cheap, and it only takes a few minutes to do it. So what you're looking at, of course, is the grill off an Edison Ambarola 30, and about one third of it is completely down to bare metal. So what I've done is taken the Ambarola 30 grill, piece of wax paper, put it down on a clean table, and I'll show you a simple and easy way to make this absolutely invisible. And here we go. Kiwi scuff cover. This is it. This stuff is great. It's not soluble in water. It is soluble in alcohol, so you can remove it. But it's not soluble in water, and it has a great affinity for waxes and oils. It's shoe polish. So no matter how much you spray this with Pledge or dust it, you'll never wipe this stuff off of it. And so how do you use it? Well, just like you're going to do shoes, but rather than wiping, we're going to be daubing, and we're going to create a virtual wood grain effect. It's really simple and it's really quick. So make sure the stuff is flowing as it is, and you're not going to do it in just 2 minutes. It's going to take about 10-15 minutes to do this, depending on how quickly the stuff dries. Watch this. Okay, and it makes a bunch of little bubbles, as you can see. And then you just let that dry. And then you do it again. And then you do it again. And after about the third or fourth time around, you filled in all of these little spots. And it's all this exact same color. You can blend this to the point where you'll never know that it was missing at all. It's really, really simple and it's really easy to do. And so, as I said, just a few minutes between daubings, and then daub it again. And every time you do it, it gets a little bit darker. And as I said, you have to let it dry just a few moments between doing this. It's a bit time consuming. Like I said, it's going to take you 10-15 minutes to do this. But as I said, you can get this so it's virtually invisible. It'll blend completely with the rest of the grill. And if you want to touch up the grill itself, just daub it on, and any metal that's showing through was almost instantly hidden. And then you just let it dry. And then once it's completely dry, just give it a light buff with a soft cloth. Spray it with some wax, Pledge, something like that. Put it back on the machine and no one will ever know that it's been damaged. So as I said, you set to let it set for just a few minutes between these applications. And the more little bubbles you can get, actually the better the effect is. And it works really, really well. And when you get this finished, you'll never know it was damaged. So it's an easy and inexpensive way to cover this metal and actually make it look wood grain. So, as I said, you know, let it dry. You can have a little fan running and speed this process up. But even if you have to do the entire thing, daub it on, let it set, daub it on, let it set, daub it on, let it set. Once it's dry, you wipe it down and you have a virtual match. So I'll go ahead and finish this. I probably won't do it in real time. I'll probably just stop the video and then take it from there. But I wanted you to show, or wanted to show you how easy it is to do this, and it's really effective and it really works. And the scuff cover is, you know, $2 a bottle, and you can touch up all kinds of things with this stuff. It works really well. So I'll let this dry a bit, and we'll come back to it. And I'll show you the completed grill for the Ambarola 30. Anyway, just a really easy way to replace the the wood graining on the Amarillo 30 grill. Okay, back again. This is part two. So this is the third application I'm going to be doing now. And it's been drying, well, probably about 15 minutes. Lots of little bubbles. That's what you want. Lots of little bubbles. And every time you do this, it covers a little bit more and a little bit more. And it darkens as it dries. So as I said, it's going to take probably four or five applications to do it. And as you can see, it's already completely a different color than it was. I mean, this was bare metal. And as it dries, it darkens. You can see the dark spot already matches the rest of the grill. So it's going to be all eventually this color. The neat thing about these little bubbles is it gives it an effect of darkness and lightness, and darkness and lightness. There's no repetitive pattern to it. So from a distance of a foot away, this really does look like wood grain. You have to get right up and look at it, and then you can see that it actually is a bunch of little bubbles. But there's a smooth pattern to it. And it really does look like wood grain. And so another application to it the most, and you will be able to repair this grill to the point where you will never know it was damaged. It's going to look just like the rest of it. You can go ahead and do a complete new metal grill. A lot of the replacement grills that are available now for the Amarillo 30 are made of wood. This also works just great for doing exactly the same thing on wood. And every time you put it on, it gets darker and darker and darker and darker. And of course, it's not soluble in water, but it is soluble in alcohol. So you can scrub this with water and it really doesn't affect it. You scrub it with alcohol, bang, it comes off straight down to the bare metal. But in the meantime, as I said, it has a great affinity for oils. And oils actually add to it rather than detract from it. Oil does not break it down. And water doesn't break it down, so you can spray it with Pledge and wipe it and dust it, and you'll never wipe this graining off of it. The only way to get it off is to actually remove it. So this is part two of the video, and as I said, you can see already that the effect is beginning, and see how it's mottled light and dark, light and dark, light and dark. That's exactly what you want, and that's basically what all of this is just mottling. And this looks like it was done with almost the same kind of application, where it's been daubed to make it resemble wood grain. It is not wood grain at all, but it sure does look like it. So go ahead and let this dry another 10 minutes or so, and I'll do part three, and we'll see how dark it got and what it takes. Like I said, it takes four or five applications to do this, depending on how badly it's been damaged. But it works with lots and lots of wood graining effect. You can hide really, really badly damaged wood grain by using this exact same effect, whether it's metal or wood. And it's quite effective, and it's really inexpensive, and it really works. As I said, you can see how this is beginning to darken now. And if you have a small fan blowing, you can do this in a matter of minutes, or somebody with a hairdryer. But just doing let it air dry, it'll take about four or five applications, depending whether it's actually down to the bare metal. And then to blend it, just go over to the rest of the grill and do a couple of daubs. And in the next few applications, this is going to be one solid color, and you will never know it was damaged. So I'll go ahead and let this dry for another 5 minutes or so, 10 minutes, and let's see how dark we got, and we'll take it from there. Okay, part three. Now it's dried for about, 10 minutes perhaps. You can already see a tremendous difference. So in the next two applications, this is virtually going to blend. And depending on how dark you want this, if you're working with a metal grill, you can leave a lot of light spots in it. And that really actually enhances the effect. The nice thing about making it dark, of course, to match, is it really hides all the imperfections. Even a badly bent grill, something that's really been tweaked, if you can get it reasonably straight and put this wood graining on it, it hides most of the imperfections in the metal. It really makes a tremendous difference in how this looks. So give it another application here. Remember, we're daubing. We're trying to create as many bubbles as possible. That's the whole idea. Let it get really foamy. That's what you're looking for. That's probably the word I should have used to begin with. Lots of foam. As that foam dries, it produces that mottled effect that so greatly resembles wood graining. And the more you can put on there at one time, the darker it will dry. And it cuts down on the number of applications. But you can only do it as fast as it dries. So it has to be not completely dry, but you have to let this stuff dry between coats so you can start putting stuff on top of the stuff that's already on there. And you can see how dark this is getting. Get lots of foam, lots of foam. There we go. And so this might be the final application, depending on how dark it dries. It's probably going to take one more. But as you can see, the dark spots that have already dried are virtually identical to the color of the rest of the grill. And then, as I said, to make this match, daub, 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 daub the whole thing. And once you're finished, you'll have a grill that looks virtually new. As I said, even one that's been pretty badly wrinkled, if you can get it reasonably flat, even though it's got a lot of waves in it, it'll disappear because the stuff doesn't reflect light. This mottled effect just seems to absorb light, and it turns into what really looks like wood graining. So we'll let this dry, and it'll take probably one more coat to fill in all these spots. It just depends on how much you can get on there, and as I said, how quickly it dries. You put a fan on this, or a hair dryer, lots of foam, lots of foam, and you can speed the process up, or if the metal's warm. But even on a table just like this, we're going to have completely refinished this grill in about half an hour or so. Alright, so we'll let it dry again, and each time you do this, it gets darker and darker and darker, and you're putting down layers, and it's a bunch of bubbles that dry as bubbles, so you're actually leaving like little mounds of this stuff on there, and then building on top of it, light, dark, light, dark, light, dark. And as I said, in another application or so, and you can blend this whole thing together, and you'll have a repaired grill. So I'll let this dry, and we'll put another application on it, see how dark it gets with this application. But you can see the general effect. It's really simple. It's really, really easy to do it. It's a bit time-consuming, simply because you have to wait for each application to dry, but you're only talking about 10 minutes or so. And so you can completely redo this grill. It's just as easy to do the entire thing as it is to do one spot. It doesn't take any longer, it's just more daubing, cover the whole thing. But we'll let this dry, and we'll give it another 10 minutes, and in the next, probably two applications, this grill will be repaired. It'll look virtually new. You'll never know that that much of the wood graining was missing. Remember, this was bare metal. So it already looks 1,000% better. So we'll let it dry, we'll come back to it, and take it from there. Greetings, part four. As you can see, the grill is repaired. So it took five coats and a grand total of about 40 minutes to do this. And as you can see, it is a virtual match to the rest of the grill. If it isn't, just daub over the rest of the grill and add that mottling, and you will have a virtual match. And I'm standing probably 2 feet away. I'm standing right behind the camera, and from this vantage point, this looks very much like wood graining. And as you can see, it matches the rest of the grill. No one would ever know this grill was damaged and down to bare metal. And it hasn't been spray painted. It hasn't been painted brown. It actually has this mottled effect to it that greatly resembles the original wood grain. as you can see for yourself. This works really well, and this Kiwi Brown Scuff cover is, I don't know, about $2 a bottle, and it is just absolutely perfect. It's that, building up that foam, and then the foam is just nothing but bubbles, and you let it dry, and that's what gives you the mottled effect. And the first coat, you can see right through it, and it darkens, and the next coat is a little darker, and the next coat is a little darker, and it eventually begins sticking to itself rather than sticking to the metal. And then after about the third or fourth coat, when the metal is completely covered, then you can really put the foam down on it and just blend all of the damage literally out of the grill. No one looking at this right now, no one would ever know that it had been damaged. What I'll probably do is go around the entire grill with one more coat. That'll make it one uniform, perfect color. But looking at it right now, no one would ever know that that was down to bare metal. I mean, it's covered it perfectly, and it's a virtual identical match to the original finish. And you saw how easy I did it. So about 40 minutes, no need to rush. It works. And you can take a completely stripped grill that's down to the bare metal, and then rather than having to spray paint it brown, you can do this effect that really resembles the original finish. As I said, it's simple, it's cheap, it's efficient, and best of all, it works. And this works on any kind of metal that has that faux wood grain on it. And it's not perfect, but it's a great camouflage. I mean, you would never know that this was damaged, and yet it hasn't been painted. It virtually replicates the finish. So just wanted to pass the tip along. Like I said, I got an email asking me about, I had mentioned in several of videos of doing a video showing you how to replicate or repair the faux wood grain on an Edison Amarillo 30 grill, and this is it. So I hope it is of value. It really does work. It's really simple. And even if you get a replacement grill that's made of wood, this exact same application, and you can match the case of the Amarillo 30, whether it's dark or light, just depending on how much you put on. And if you run into a problem or if you don't like it, take it back off. As I said, it's not soluble in water. So you can spray this with Windex, you can spray it with Pledge and keep it dusted without ever having to worry about this stuff coming off. But if you do want to take it off, plain old 91% isopropyl alcohol, or better yet, some denatured alcohol, zap, and you can just literally wipe this down back to the bare metal. In the meantime, it is completely inert. It just sits there. It doesn't rub off, it's never going to be touched, it's not going to wear off, and it's not soluble in water. That's the important thing. So it has a great affinity for oils, and Pledge brings it to life. It really, really seems to like that. It is shoe polish, after all. So anyway, I just wanted to pass this along. It works. It's really simple, and it's really inexpensive. And it only takes a few minutes to do it. And it gives you really, really satisfactory results. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Answer all my email. Try to answer the day I get it. So if you have any questions on virtually anything I've covered in my YouTube series, recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph, these little repairs. If you do have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.